but by the token of this faltering breath, this chill at heart, this dampness on my brow.
Has never, never.
painting soul and play the man. And through such waning span of life and thought, as still has to be trod, prepare to meet my God. And while the storm of that bewilderment is for a season spent, and ere afresh the ruin on me fall, use well the interval. Still a fear.
fierce and restless fright begins to fill the mansions of my soul. And worse, some bodily form of ill flows on the wind with many a loathsome curse. Tainting the hallowed air, and laughs and flaps its hideous wings, and makes me wild with horror, horror and dismay. Came Tells me I am not self-moving, but born forward on my way. And hark, I hear a sea. Yet in sooth I cannot of that music rightly say whether I hear or touch or taste the tones. Oh, what a heart subduing
is a member of that family of wondrous beings who ever worlds were made millions of ages back have stood around the throne of God. I will address him, mighty one, my Lord, my guardian spirit. All hail.
All hail, my child and brother. Hail, what wouldst thou?
I would have nothing but to speak with thee for speaking's sake. I wish to hold with thee conscious communion, though I fain would know a maze of things, were it but meet to ask, and not a curiousness.
You cannot now cherish a wish which ought not to be.
Forthwith it fell.
Falls upon thee.
my sense comes a fierce hubbub, which would make me fear, could I be frighted.
We are now arrived close on the judgment course. That sullen howl is from the demons who assemble here.
Ah!
those false spirits? Shall I see my dearest master when I reach his throne? Yes, for one moment.
is like the rushing of the wind, the summer wind among the lofty pines.
Glory to him who ever holds the eyes to address his grace. Praise the Lord.
Possessed of its soul, peace.